Today we're going to talk about PTFE rotary seals. PTFE is more commonly known in the industry as Teflon, but today we're going to refer to it as PTFE because Teflon is the DuPont trade name. Reasons we would choose to use PTFE over your normal rubber elastomer style seal would be that we've exceeded the capabilities, whether it be speed, pressure, temperature, and maybe the chemicals that it comes in contact with. PTFE is a very low friction material, so it's able to operate at very high speeds. It's got a very broad temperature range. Virgin PTFE can handle ranges from minus 425 Fahrenheit up to 450 Fahrenheit. And we can even shift that range a little higher depending on the fillers that we add to it. So it can handle a wide range of temperature, and basically any fluid or chemical that you throw at it, it's going to be compatible with. So it's very good there. Got a couple different styles I'd like to talk about today. This one over here is going to be used when you have very high speeds but relatively low pressure. And over here is going to be kind of the opposite. Somewhat low to medium speeds but significantly higher pressures. So for this one, we've got very lightly loaded and very flexible lips that are machined. They're very lightly engaged, so we need a shaft that runs very true, no run out, because PTFE is not a very resilient material. It needs some form of energizer in order to make sure that it remains in contact with the shaft. So with this profile here, we're going to be limited to about 50 PSI, but we can run up to about 5,000 surface feet per minute for speeds. We've got an excluder and then a main lip to retain the fluid. We can change that a little bit. We could do away with that lip and possibly add a redundant lip for fluid retention. Something like that. If we had additional pressure, we could reinforce this a little bit with a metal band, increasing the rigidity of it. If we did something like that, we could increase the pressure rating of up to 150 PSI. If we did have a little bit of runout that we needed to handle, we could modify this lip a little bit, include a little what we would call an elf toe, and then we could add a small spring right there to help the lip maintain contact with the shaft. But still, the runout has to be pretty minimal. We're talking about maybe 20 thousandths depending on the speed. If we shift gears and go over to this other style where we're looking at high pressure but relatively low speed, the pressure rating on this profile would be about 3,000 PSI, and your surface speed is going to be limited to about 1,000 surface feet per minute. We've got quite a few different options as far as lip styles. We can do a traditional scraper lip, which is good at scraping fluid and keeping contaminants out. We could change the lip style to a taper, and that's going to be better for sealing and lower friction. Several different spring options. I've got the cantilever or V-spring shown in there right now. Another option would be a canted coil if we wanted to reduce the lip loading a little bit. And we've got several different options for the bore. We could eliminate this O-ring and do a flanged design. And then this flange would get clamped in the hardware, and that ensures that the seal cannot rotate in the bore. Allows you to increase your speed rating just a little bit also. If we needed to go higher than the 3000 PSI for pressure, we could extend this heel a little bit. Beefs the heel up a little bit and makes it a lot more rigid, a lot more stable profile. So something like this, there would be an O-ring in there as well. This could bump our pressure rating up to close to 10,000 PSI. So we've got a wide range of possibilities with PTFE. And we can tailor the fillers depending on the application conditions and the performance criteria needed. There's a wide range of additives that we can put in the PTFE to tailor to the needs. A wide range of applications that these seals can be used in. A lot of times you'll see them in gearboxes or motors, pressure washers where we've got high pressure, rotary unions and swivels, compressors. The virgin PTFE is FDA compliant, so it's a good option for those types of applications. Cryogenics, due to the wide temperature range, and robotics are pretty common too. Another benefit of PTFE versus a rubber elastomer seal is that there's no tooling required for these. These get machined out of a sleeve or billet of material. So prototyping and initial samples are very fast and inexpensive. And that's it for PTFE seals.